What is up, guys? Welcome back to the channel. Today I'm going to be showing you guys how to jailbreak iOS 12.5.7. It's really easy to do and there's no computer needed. But before we do that, make sure to hit the like button and subscribe to this channel. That way you never miss an upload and it helps this channel out a lot. Alright, so the first thing we're going to do is go into Settings, then scroll down and go into General, and go into About. And in here you're going to make sure you're on iOS 12.5.7. If you are not on iOS 12.5.7, this jailbreak may not work for you. If you're on the iPhone 5S, 6, or 6 Plus, you can just update straight to 12.5.7. So now that we know we're on iOS 12.5.7, we're going to go out of Settings, then we'll go into Safari, and then we're going to type in this URL. The URL is ipa-apps.me/links/freya.php. So go ahead and put in that link, and then we'll tap Go. And you're gonna see this wait screen. So we're going to tap skip this ad. It's probably going to do a pop-up. So you're just gonna close out of that if it does pop up and then just click it again. And then typically on that second attempt, it will bring up something like this that says it would like to install Freya. So you're gonna install that and then head to the home screen. And here you can see it installing. And it's done now, but we can't get into it just yet. You're gonna see it's gonna have untrusted enterprise developer. So what we need to do is go into Settings, then go to wherever the main screen is. So we gotta back out of that. You might already be on it, but once you're on this main screen, we're gonna head into General. Then we're gonna go all the way down. Then you're gonna see Device Management here. We're gonna go into that. And then you're gonna see something here. It might not always be the same thing. This is just what mine's called, but yours may be different. So you're gonna go into whatever's up here. And then you're going to click Trust, Trust again, then head back to the main screen, swipe on over, and you should be able to get into it now. So we're just going to tap OK here, and then go ahead and click Jailbreak. So the first thing it's going to do, it's going to have us reboot the device. And then once it's done, we're gonna go back into it. And then on the side, we still have the same app, so we're gonna go back into it. And then once again, we're gonna click Jailbreak. So it says that it has successfully completed the jailbreak, so we're gonna go ahead and respring it. Go back in again, and here we go, we have Cydia. Now it is jailbroken now, but we are not done yet. There is a couple things left to do, so what we're gonna do is go into Cydia. We're gonna wait for the sources to be done. And you're gonna see it's gonna ask you to do an upgrade. We're gonna do a complete upgrade to make sure that it's fully secure, then click Confirm. Once that's done, click Return to Cydia. And now your device is completely jailbroken. So now I'm going to show you what happens if you try to reboot your device, or if your phone happens to die, or anything of that nature happens. I'm going to show you how to keep your device jailbroken in that event. So I'm going to turn off the device, and now we're rebooting it. And so now after it's rebooted, if you ever do that with your phone or if it dies, once it's back on, you're gonna see if you try to go into Cydia, it's gonna crash. And the reason for that is that it has been rebooted into a non-jailbroken state. So in order to fix this, we need to go back into Freya. And you're gonna see at the bottom, this time it says enable Freya. It doesn't say jailbreak anymore. So that's what you need to do every time you reboot your phone or if it dies, you're gonna have to do that every single time that happens. And so I'll go ahead and do that now. And then once again, respring. And now after that, we should be able to go right back into Cydia and have our jailbreak back. So now your phone is fully jailbroken and you know what to do in the case of a restart. And so from here, you can add whatever tweaks you want to add to make this thing more usable in 2023. But yeah, this jailbreak can definitely help breathe some new life into these old phones. So guys, thank you so much for watching this video and supporting the channel. If you liked this video and it helped you out, make sure to hit the like button and subscribe to this channel because I make tons of content like this. And once again, it really does help this channel. And I'll see you in the next video.